The Urals. Primeval forests cloak Russia's most ancient mountains. Its sentinels of stone guard this rugged sanctuary. Here, icons of the wild must struggle to survive. This vast wilderness is witness to remarkable tales of life and death. Enter Russia's secret forests, the Urals. Russia's wilderness is vast and untamed. Few have traveled to its farthest reaches. But now, wild Russia has gained exclusive access, revealing snow-capped mountains, smoldering volcanoes, endless tundra, and great forests. This is a wilderness unlike any other on Earth. Russia's 6.5 million square miles includes a rugged region dominated by a 1,500 mile long backbone of mountains, the Urals. The Ural Mountains were formed more than 250 million years ago. Over time, wind and water have worn them down into low, rolling mountains covered in ancient forests. It's an ideal refuge for Russia's exiles, animals fleeing the advance of civilization. Some trees have guarded the wildlife here for centuries. They bear witness to the struggles of two of this region's rarest creatures. One is the Russian Desmond, and it's found nowhere else on Earth. This water-loving mammal is highly elusive, and catching this rare creature on film in the wild is astonishing. With a nose like a hedgehog and paws like a platypus, this odd-looking creature is related to the mole. And like the mole, it's almost entirely blind. Instead of sight, the Desmond relies on touch, using his long whiskers and sensory hairs on his body to feel his way around. Equally at home on land or in water, he can remain submerged for up to 5 minutes without a breath. Hunted for its lush fur, the Desmond had almost entirely vanished from the wild by the early 1900s. Today, there are 27,000 Desmonds left on the planet, all in the Urals. And unfortunately, their numbers continue to decline. Farther north, the forest conceals another mammal, but this one teeters on the very brink of extinction. Like the Desmond, the European mink was hunted so aggressively for its fur, it almost disappeared entirely. Today, there are less than 5,000 European mink in the world, making it one of Russia's most endangered mammals. But this female is about to increase the mink population, if only by a few. First, she must prepare her den. As a storm brews above, our cameras witness a birth seen by few. The first of the mink's tiny newborns comes into view. Mother and Kit are still linked by the umbilical cord. After she licks her kit clean, she bites through the cord. It's a victory for the mother and her species. There are more young to come. Outside, the weather has calmed. A soaked owl chick preens, oblivious to the events unfolding just below. It's a tranquil scene. The exhausted mother can finally relax, surrounded by her squirming newborns. But the sound of a squirrel alarms her. As she steps outside, she reveals five healthy mink kits, each weighing less than half an ounce. While her precious kits spell hope for the future of the species, other creatures fight more commonplace battles. It's early spring, but snow still covers the ground, and food is scarce. Eurasian elk, called moose in North America, are the largest of the deer family. Females can weigh up to 700 pounds, and males up to 1,700. These females are hungry, and tempers are running short. Like giant-sized boxers, females fight by striking with their front feet. Cold weather fuels the elk's already hefty appetites. They'll consume about 45 pounds of twigs daily. In their never-ending quest for food, they inevitably cross paths with the enemy. Just out of hibernation, a brown bear is on the hunt. Although still groggy, this top predator could still outrun and kill an elk. But the deep snow is unexpected, and his fumbling footsteps alert the elk. It's a disappointing start after 6 months of fasting. Until the snow melts, he'll eat vegetarian fare. The dense forests of the Urals are slow to make way for spring. They cloak more than 60,000 square miles of pristine wilderness. But spring is mating season, even if there's still snow on the ground. This black grouse searches for a mate. Males woo females with a unique bubbling sound called roo-cooing. His love song attracts the unwanted attention of a hungry wolverine. The carnivore's presence breaks the romantic mood. They'll continue their courtship on safer ground. Wolverines, the largest of the weasel family, will travel up to 40 miles a day in search of food. But this one takes a moment to groom himself with a brisk roll on the ground. As the snow melts, streams cut fresh paths through the forest and feed hundreds of rivers along the length of the Urals. For Eurasian elk, the welcome thaw can also bring danger. Their migration takes them across newly swollen, fast-flowing rivers. In the water, they can reach speeds of nearly 6 miles per hour and can travel as far as 12 miles. But swift rising water drags many to their death each year. Only the strongest will reach the safety of the shore. It's spring in Russia's Ural Mountains, and rivers swell with the melting snow. Elk weigh in at nearly a ton, but they're good swimmers. Still, every year, some elk don't make it. A younger, less experienced elk soon runs into trouble. She's pushed downstream, away from the herd. If she tires, the icy currents will drag her under. This time, the young elk is lucky, and she'll quickly catch up with the herd. As the elk continue their travels, others bask in the milder spring temperatures. The sun ignites the passion of spotted red fire bugs. Their red color warns predators of the foul odor they can emit in defense. To mate, they pair up end to end. Every year, it's a mating marathon. Males and females will remain linked while they mate, sometimes up to 7 days at a time. In other parts of the forest, spring is a time for feasting. This wolf has caught the scent of an elk carcass. But he's not the only hungry one. In the hierarchy of the forest, the bear is king. He's used to getting his way. He heads straight for an elk carcass he stashed some time ago. Brown bears often bury the remains of a kill for safekeeping and return to them days later. If he wants to share in the spoils, the wolf must be patient. But an adult bear can eat up to 90 pounds of food a day. He's in no rush to leave. It's a remarkable standoff. Two icons of the Russian wilderness, face to face. Eventually, the wolf gives up. He leaves the brown bear with his feast, basking in victory. Spring is an easy time for the wildlife of the Ural Mountains. Frequent rainfall is followed by mild, sunny days. Rains turn the plains into an expansive swamp. This is bear territory. The brown bear used to be one of the most widespread mammals on Earth. Now, the species is threatened. But Russia is the bear's stronghold, home to more than half of the world's total population of 120,000. Even so, there are only 4,000 brown bears left in the Urals. Spring is mating season, and this male approaches a female with caution. Females will mate with males only every 3 to 5 years, so they pick their partners carefully. Once they give birth, they won't mate again until their cub is ready to fend for itself. In an extraordinary adaptation, once the female mates, the embryo won't implant or grow until late fall, up to 5 months after mating. This ensures she'll give birth to her cubs in the safety of the hibernation den. The mating game is far less controlled in the wet forest interior. Dull male moor frogs turn an enticing shade of blue to impress females. Not that they are all that choosy. In their passion, male frogs may try to mate with anything that has a heartbeat, even a toad. Thankfully, enough get it right and spawn fills the water. Elsewhere in the forest, other young take their first steps on the dangerous climb to adulthood. Russia's Urals form a natural boundary between Europe and Asia. The rolling mountains cloaked in forest stretch as far as the eye can see. This is the site of one of Russia's most spectacular natural wonders, called Mount Pupuner. Limestone towers up to 265 feet tall rise mysteriously from the hill. Local legend calls them the Seven Strong Men, telling of brothers magically transformed into stone. As night falls over the ancient brothers, a Ural owl comes out to hunt down below. And this enchanted forest brings a curse upon a hapless frog. Ural owls prefer small mammals, but this one has two chicks to feed. He can't afford to be picky. It's a bright spring morning, and the owlets are wide awake. At around 5 weeks old, they grow eager to explore. The fact that they can't yet fly isn't an issue. They master the slow plummet and the graceful hop. But the winged-assisted tree climb still needs some work. While the smaller siblings stay safe in the nest hole, the adventurer searches for a new feeding post. As long as the chicks stay out of trouble, the parent pays little attention. In the spring, youngsters, large and small, roam the forest with their parents. This mother bear keeps her two young cubs very close. They'll nurse for up to 2.5 years and stay with her for 3. Playtime ends when the mother catches the scent of another bear. Taking no chances, she and her cubs move on. With 1,200-pound males prowling the forest for mates, she's right to be wary. Males will kill cubs to bring their mothers back into heat. Nearby, a second older female has 3 cubs trailing behind. 3 is the typical litter size, with 4 usually the maximum. Another bear comes close, but the experienced mother hardly flinches. It's a young male, and she has the advantage of size. The cubs can get on with their antics. It looks like fun, but play is also an essential learning tool for survival in the wild. Threats are never far off. When the mother smells another male nearby, she has her cubs practice their tree climbing drill. While the male rubs his scent on the branches, she and the cubs slip undetected into the woods. Without warning, the weather takes an ominous turn. The wind picks up, whipping through the hills at speeds of over 60 miles an hour. The owl chicks are in peril as the violent storm rolls in. In Russia's Urals, the arrival of summer is welcomed by all. Ural owl chicks have just braved their first storm. They're almost ready to take care of themselves. Though not quite. Their parents still deliver their food. This time around, it's a rabbit's leg. The owl's digestive system dissolves the meat, leaving the bone to come back up later. As the owlets relax, a summer storm soaks the northern forests. This bear hardly notices. An outer coat of coarse hair repels water, keeping him dry. A damselfly is one of hundreds of different insect species attracted to the damp forest conditions and the rich plant diversity. The sprawling ancient forest provides a safe haven for many. Having taken refuge under the leafy canopy, this female elk has reason to welcome the cool shade. Elk breed in the fall, and after 8 months, females give birth in the seclusion of the forest. Her fawn is already nimble on its legs. It will drink up to 2 quarts of milk a day for 5 months. Only when she's ready to deliver her new offspring the following year will she push her calf to fend for himself. Although elk have no upper front teeth, they're skilled at eating woody plants that make up most of their diet. In the summer, the elk supplements its woody diet with green plant leaves and shoots. The elk's fawn will stay with its mother for up to a year, a luxurious amount of time compared to the 2 or 4 months a mink kid gets. The mink's mother has just returned to the den to an enthusiastic welcome. At 5 weeks old, the kits have finally opened their eyes. In his excitement, the smallest steps out of the burrow into a world full of perils. The mother goes to the rescue, but she may not always be on hand to protect her fragile family. Beyond the den, the wilderness of the Urals is immense. Its rivers teem with wildlife. Moles prefer to dig in the dirt, but they're sturdy but slow swimmers, covering only about a half a mile per hour. With a wealth of animals and its ancient forests, the World Wildlife Fund declared the Urals one of the most important regions for conservation. In the north, brown bears roam through the cotton grass, a plant that thrives in the wetlands here. They share the territory with wild forest reindeer, but rarely catch them. These reindeer don't make long migrations like their northern relatives. Instead, they stay in the forests throughout the year. With around 20 deer in a herd, they have plenty of eyes to spot trouble, and they need every one of them. Bears are a constant threat, but it's spring, and mating season is in full swing. Usually, the mating season is an aggressive time, but these two bears are especially tender, sharing a rare moment of intimacy. Once the male bear has mated repeatedly with the female, he'll leave her alone for good. If he's lucky, her cubs will carry his genes. But once he's gone, she's just as likely to mate with other males. While some Ural residents focus on mating, others fixate on meals. The wolverine may look small, but its fierce reputation precedes it. They'll chase wolves away from kills, and even brown bears will step aside. Like bears, wolverines stash their food, sometimes hiding it for up to 6 months. This one seems shocked to find its deer carcass exposed and devoured. But all is not lost. It can still pick a meal from these remains. Wolverine's jaws easily crush bone. And they'll eat almost anything, including antlers, fur, and even teeth. Further down the riverbank, this mink is after something a little fresher. These adept underwater hunters chase frogs, snails, fish, and insects. Her home range may stretch 9 miles along the banks. But she won't stray far. It's too dangerous. Already, she's lost two of her original litter of 5 kits. Unless she returns with food soon, her remaining 3 offspring won't survive. A good bite subdues a common roach, and it's set aside while she hunts for more. She can't see well underwater, so she relies on her keen sense of smell to detect prey. Coming up empty, she returns to the fish and heads home. Once on land, her fur will shed water. She'll be dry by the time she reaches the burrow. A quick drop-off, and she's back to hunting again. This time, she's after food for herself. And deeper in the forest, the largest predator around is after something sweet. Summer casts a warm glow over Russia's southern Ural Mountains. Here, the Belaya River crosses the Shulgin-Tash Reserve. It's 87 square miles of densely forested and fully protected wilderness, a perfect home for bears. Bears can be a serious threat to their enemies. On average, they can weigh 0.5 ton and can charge at 30 miles per hour. But this bear's more itchy than angry. Summer temperatures reach 60 degrees, hot for a brown bear. Deep in the reserves are the man-made hives of the rare and endangered Burzian bees. There are dozens of artificial hives, each filled with honey. They're a perfect target for bears with a sweet tooth. Drips at the base of the tree give a small taste of what hangs above. You'll have to climb to get more from the actual hive. But he's too heavy. He leaves hungry for more. Competition for the prized honey is fierce. This time, it's a mother with young. A lightweight cub has a better chance of reaching the hive. The mother would do well to move with a 400-pound wooden hive dangling overhead. What the little one lacks in experience, he makes up for in enthusiasm. Sitting on top of a hive full of hot-tempered bees may not be the best way to harvest honey, but options are limited. He's lucky. In the wild, these bees nest in tree cavities, and their honey is far harder to reach. Eventually, the hive drops. The plan: eat quickly and get away. The bear's thick fur helps prevent stings, but poking their faces into the hive is asking for trouble. Honey is a great source of calories for the bears, which need to pile on weight before the winter. It's worth a few stings. But the plenty of summer will soon give way to the hardships of winter. Autumn arrives, and the forest wears a vibrant yellow coat. It's a signal that temperatures will soon fall and food will become scarce. Animals rush to stock up for the coming winter. As the weather cools, magpies and jays fight over seeds dropped from the bushes. They don't have much time to gather what they need before the brutal winter returns. Every creature in the forest is on full alert. Winter's approach can be sudden. In Russia's Ural Mountains, fall brings cooler temperatures. Winter is approaching. As maple leaves turn, the rut begins, and forest dwellers hunt out berries before the snows arrive. Male reindeer now sport impressive antlers for the autumn rut, or mating season. While the reindeer ready for battle, a bear readies for the long hibernation. His approach sends the reindeer fleeing up the valley, away from danger. Bears eat a wide variety of foods, including grasses, roots, fish, insects, and other mammals. Berries provide an energy boost. And when food is plentiful, these usually solitary bears will tolerate each other. Every bear must pack on enough pounds to survive the 6-month hibernation. The plants benefit from the bear's relentless feasting. Bears can't digest the seeds. It's nature's way of planting the forest. And seeds come wrapped in fertilizer. Elsewhere in the Urals, this group of male elk makes a final attempt to attract mates as autumn ends. Bull's antlers are the largest of any mammal, and they regrow every year. In 5 months, they can span 6.5 feet and weigh up to 70 pounds. It's the fastest growing bone on the planet. Though they're in competition, they keep a respectful distance rather than waste energy locking antlers. When winter arrives in the Urals, it comes with a vengeance. The settling snow outlines a frozen landscape, haunted by an eerie sound. A sudden drop in temperature causes tree bark to burst and split, filling the forest with a strange percussion. The elk pass like silent shadows through the darkened trees. They'll brave the cold and the predators. With the big chill, the search for food gets harder for all wildlife in the Urals. Wolves can sniff out prey from a mile and a half away. But the elk are on to them, putting their own keen noses to use. Although wolves have the stamina and determination to track prey over great distances, they simply can't keep up. Fortunately, they can go up to a week without eating. During the course of winter, the Urals forests become buried in drifts of up to 10 feet deep. The trees will endure this freeze for 6 months until spring releases them from winter's grip. For centuries, the vast forests of the Urals have endured these vicious winters. More recently, they've withstood the advance of civilization. The Urals. This expanse of ancient wilderness is the magnificent backbone of wild Russia. And it remains invincible. The Urals. Primeval forests cloak Russia's most ancient mountains. Its sentinels of stone guard this rugged sanctuary. Here, icons of the wild must struggle to survive. This vast wilderness is witness to remarkable tales of life. Enter Russia's secret forests, the Urals. Russia's wilderness is vast and untamed. Few have traveled to its farthest reaches. But now, wild Russia has gained exclusive access, revealing snow-capped mountains, smoldering volcanoes, endless tundra, and great forests. This is a wilderness unlike any other on Earth. Russia's 6.5 million square miles includes a rugged region, dominated by a 1,500-mile-long backbone of mountains, the Urals. The Ural Mountains were formed more than 250 million years ago. Over time, wind and water have worn them down into low, rolling mountains covered in ancient forests. It's an ideal refuge for Russia's exiles, animals fleeing the advance of civilization. Some trees have guarded the wildlife here for centuries. They bear witness to the struggles of two of this region's rarest creatures. One is the Russian Desman, and it's found nowhere else on Earth. This water-loving mammal is highly elusive, and catching this rare creature on film in the wild is astonishing. With a nose like a hedgehog and paws like a platypus, this odd-looking creature is related to the mole. And like the mole, it's almost entirely blind. Instead of sight, the Desman relies on touch, using his long whiskers and sensory hairs on his body to feel his way around. Equally at home on land or in water, he can remain submerged for up to 5 minutes without a breath. Hunted for its lush fur, the Desman had almost entirely vanished from the wild by the early 1900s. Today, there are 27,000 Desmonds left on the planet, all in the Urals. And unfortunately, their numbers continue to decline. Farther north, the forest conceals another mammal, but this one teeters on the very brink of extinction. Like the Desman, the European mink was hunted so aggressively for its fur, it almost disappeared entirely. Today, there are less than 5,000 European mink in the world, making it one of Russia's most endangered mammals. But this female is about to increase the mink population, if only by a few. First, she must prepare her den. As a storm brews above, our cameras witness a birth seen by few. The first of the mink's tiny newborns comes into view. Mother and kit are still linked by the umbilical cord. After she licks her kit clean, she bites through the cord. It's a victory for the mother and her species. There are more young to come. Outside, the weather has calmed. A soaked owl chick preens, oblivious to the events unfolding just below. It's a tranquil scene. The exhausted mother can finally relax, surrounded by her squirming newborns. But the sound of a squirrel alarms her. As she steps outside, she reveals 5 healthy mink kits, each weighing less than half an ounce. While her precious kits spell hope for the future of the species, other creatures fight more commonplace battles. It's early spring, but snow still covers the ground, and food is scarce. Eurasian elk, called moose in North America, are the largest of the deer family. Females can weigh up to 700 pounds, and males up to 1,700. These females are hungry, and tempers are running short. Like giant-sized boxers, females fight by striking with their front feet. Cold weather fuels the elk's already hefty appetites. They'll consume about 45 pounds of twigs daily. In their never-ending quest for food, they inevitably cross paths with the enemy. Just out of hibernation, a brown bear is on the hunt. Although still groggy, this top predator could still outrun and kill an elk. But the deep snow is unexpected, and his fumbling footsteps alert the elk. It's a disappointing start after 6 months of fasting. Until the snow melts, he'll eat vegetarian fare. The dense forests of the Urals are slow to make way for spring. They cloak more than 60,000 square miles of pristine wilderness. But spring is mating season, even if there's still snow on the ground. This black grouse searches for a mate. Males woo females with a unique bubbling sound called roo-cooing. His love song attracts the unwanted attention of a hungry wolverine. The carnivore's presence breaks the romantic mood. They'll continue their courtship on safer ground. Wolverines, the largest of the weasel family, will travel up to 40 miles a day in search of food. But this one takes a moment to groom himself with a brisk roll on the ground. As the snow melts, streams cut fresh paths through the forest and feed hundreds of rivers along the length of the Urals. For Eurasian elk, the welcome thaw can also bring danger. Their migration takes them across newly swollen, fast-flowing rivers. In the water, they can reach speeds of nearly 6 miles per hour and can travel as far as 12 miles. But swift rising water drags many to their death each year. Only the strongest will reach the safety of the shore. It's spring in Russia's Ural Mountains, and rivers swell with the melting snow. Elk weigh in at nearly a ton, but they're good swimmers. Still, every year, some elk don't make it. A younger, less experienced elk soon runs into trouble. She's pushed downstream, away from the herd. If she tires, the icy currents will drag her under. This time, the young elk is lucky. and she'll quickly catch up with the herd. As the elk continue their travels, others bask in the milder spring temperatures. The sun ignites the passion of spotted red fire bugs. Their red color warns predators of the foul odor they can emit in defense. To mate, they pair up end to end. Every year, it's a mating marathon. Males and females will remain linked while they mate, sometimes up to 7 days at a time. In other parts of the forest, spring is a time for feasting. This wolf has caught the scent of an elk carcass. But he's not the only hungry one. In the hierarchy of the forest, the bear is king. He's used to getting his way. He heads straight for an elk carcass he stashed some time ago. Brown bears often bury the remains of a kill for safekeeping and return to them days later. If he wants to share in the spoils, the wolf must be patient. But an adult bear can eat up to 90 pounds of food a day. He's in no rush to leave. It's a remarkable standoff. Two icons of the Russian wilderness, face to face. Eventually, the wolf gives up. He leaves the brown bear with his feast, basking in victory. Spring is an easy time for the wildlife of the Ural Mountains. Frequent rainfall is followed by mild, sunny days. Rains turn the plains into an expansive swamp. This is bear territory. The brown bear used to be one of the most widespread mammals on Earth. Now, the species is threatened. But Russia is the bear's stronghold, home to more than half of the world's total population of 120,000.